is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 5th Chapter, text number 25, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 6, 1974, in Vrindavan, India.
Uchistalipan Anumodito Dijai Sakisma Bunji Tadapasta Kilmishaha Evang Prabhittasya Vishuddha Chetasa Sadharma Eva Atmaruchi Prajaya. Very simple process of awakening Krishna consciousness. This Atmaruchi. Atmaruchi means attraction for the self or soul. There are Atma. Atma means sometimes this body. Jasyatma buddhi nape siddhat. Gross materialists, they think that I am this body. That is also atmaruchi. They are busy to maintain this body, to decorate this body, to feed this body, to satisfy the senses of the body. And this is also atmaruchi. Because the body is also called Atma. So, this is another Atmaruchi, materialistic. And then, Atma means mind also. Mental speculation, very much busy in mental speculation. That is also Atmaruchi. And the topmost Atmaruchi, topmost means that is real Atmaruchi. To be attracted by the self or super self, that is Atmaruchi. So our business is to awaken that supreme Atmaruchi. That is Krishna consciousness. Supreme Atmaruchi, supreme Atma. Krishna says, matta paratara nanya. You can take in different platform, different kinds of attraction. But when our attraction is in Krishna, that is supreme. So, just like for bodily comforts, there are so many scientists, physiologists, biologists, they are trying to understand the constitution of the body. They are busy. And similarly, mental speculators, philosophers, they are also busy. Similarly, the ultimate Atmaruchi, if we want to know, then we should be busy with such persons who are engaged in that type of Atmaruchi. That is called Sadhu Sangha. Sangat Sanjayate Kama. As you associate, so your desires become, attached. So here it is said that Dijayi, Uchistulipan Unmodita Dijayi. Dijayi, the Brahmana, and the supreme Brahmana is the devotee Krishna Ika Saran. So Narad Muni, in his previous birth, he was engaged in washing the dishes, eating the foodstuff left by the Vijay, by the Brahmanas. In this way, he infected their disease. As in ordinary material sense, if you eat the remnants of foodstuff of a diseased fellow, and then you infect the disease. Therefore, sometimes when there is a patient suffering from tuberculosis, it is strictly separated from the family to another room or another house, so that it is very infectious. Cholera is very infectious. Smallpox is very much infectious. There are many infectious diseases. So, as you infect this material disease by eating the foodstuff left by a diseased fellow, similarly, if you eat the remnants of foodstuff left by Vaishnava, you become Vaishnava. This is infection. So we should voluntarily accept this infection. The other infection we should avoid. And this infection we shall welcome. But the process is the same. Param drishtya nivartate. You can refrain from the lower class of infection simply by infecting yourself with the higher class or transcendental class of infection. So Narad Muni, you as a small boy, it was not possible for him to study Vedanta or philosophy. He was not even educated, but still, simply by eating the remnants of foodstuff left by the devotees, Vijay, he became so exalted. The explanation is given there. The evaṁ pravittasya viśuddha cetas. Because I was engaged in this service, gradually my heart became clean. Viśuddha cetas. Cetasa means heart. So, actually, Krishna consciousness is there. As it is stated in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Nitya Siddha Krishna Bhakti. Because we are part and parcel of Krishna. Just like father and son. However, there may be misunderstanding, but if the father and son come together and their affectionate dealings is began, immediately original relationship is revived. It does not take much time. Similarly, we are already related with Krishna, because Krishna says, Mama Ivaṁsa Jīva Bhūta. All living entities are my part and parcel. Aham Bīja Pradapita. I am the seed-giving father. So how this relation can be broken? That is not possible. That is already there, eternal. Therefore, it is said in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Nitya Siddha Krishna Bhakti. Nitya Siddha means eternally perfect. It is not that we are artificially acquiring this Krishna Bhakti. No, it is not artificial. It is natural. This is actual fact. We are simply because our present, in the present material condition, our heart is covered with so much garbage of different types of body. Just like all of a sudden something comes to your mind. It has no connection. Just like a bubble comes up. Because so many dirty things are reserved on account of our material condition and life for millions and millions of years. Anadi karma phale pori bhavar navo jale. Anadi, we cannot. Adi means the creation. So before this creation, bhutta puliyat, we are in this material contamination, not that in this millennium. Before they just like millennium after millennium. Narad Muni was speaking his life before this millennium. So, anadi means creation, that not only one creation, several creation, we are forgotten. We are in this material world. Krishna Bhuliyaji Bhogavan. We are searching after material comfort, sense gratification in so many ways. So, anadi karma phale pari bhavan na bhajale. Parivare na dekhi upaya. In this way you are going. So, consciousness is there, but the dirty things contaminated life after life, that is accumulated. We have to cleanse this. And that is called Vishuddha Chetas. Vishuddha Chetas. Just like infection of disease can be also disinfected by injection, by vaccine. Similarly, if you take this vaccine or antiseptic, what is that called? Counteracting? Inoculation and so on. There are different terms. So, this is the process. We are eternally related with Krishna. Nitya Siddha Krishna Bhakti. And you are eternally very affectionate and obedient servant of Krishna. That is our position. Somehow or other it is covered. So that garbage, this covering, has to be moved. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Chita Darpana Marjanam. This is the process of cleansing the mirror of the heart. The mirror, when it is covered by dust, you cannot see your face nicely. But as soon as it is nicely brushed and cleansed, you see exactly what you are. Similarly, the Krishna consciousness movement means cleansing the heart of all the dirty things that is accumulated life after life. It is not an artificial thing we are learning to become devotee of Krishna. We are already devotee of Krishna. But we have forgotten. Or the consciousness is covered. Now, by this process, devotional process, especially by kirtan, by chanting, glorifying the holy name of the Lord, the cleansing process is accelerated. Very soon it takes place. Hirtanadeva Krishnasya Mukta Sangha Param Brajet. This is the facility of this age, Kali Yuga. This is the only facility. And Kali Yuga, you cannot perform meditation or perform big, big sacrifices as they are mentioned in the Vedas. Or you cannot perform in deity worship very nicely, there are so many flaws. everything is very difficult. And charity, and there are so many. Samena, samena, danena, tyagena. Then where is the money I shall, There is no money even to feed me. I am eating this morning, I do not know what shall I eat in the evening. This is the position at the present moment. Prayane alpa ayusa, kalo vasmin yugijana. The life is also very short duration. And so many disturbances. Not only disturbance of the Kali Yuga, by the disturbance by the government also, by the demigods, there is scorching heat, there is a severe cold, and on Ativrishti sometimes more than we want, there is rainfall, sometimes there is no rainfall, and in this way the scarcity of foodstuff, anavrishti, dudbikha, and taxation. These are the disturbances. So many. One side taxation by the government, another side by nature. There is scarcity of food, and there is scarcity of rain. So these are stated in the Bhagavata. Dudbikha, anavrishti, dudbikha, karopirita. People will be so much disturbed. It is already disturbed. Gacchanti Grikananam. They will leave their home, their family, and go to the forest, go to the hills, disgusted. So, this is the Kali Yuga symptom. So how one will clean the heart? He cannot sit even peacefully for a moment, disturbed. Always disturbing the mind, anxiety, full of anxiety. How it will be possible to meditate? This is all nonsense. This is not possible. In Kali Yuga, meditation is not possible. The so-called meditation is a farce. Those who are trying to meditate, therefore you don't see any improvement in their life. Then making a formal meditation, but they remain what they are. Don't improve anything. That is not possible. So, therefore in this age, it is recommended that kriti jat dhayato vishnu tritayang jajato makhai dapare parichajyayam kalo tad harikirtana. Simply chant Hare Krishna. That is the only way. There is no other method. There are methods, but you cannot perform it. You are so condemned. You means we also, everyone. We are so condemned, and the age is so condemned, that it is very, very difficult. It is not possible. And another process is this, as Narada Muni says, Uchchishta lepana anumodita dijai, to serve the devotee, a pure devotee. If you serve someone or other, you contaminate his quality. Tad dharma. Sakrit bhunje, one side is apasma kilmisha. Kilmisha means sinful reaction applied. So reduce the reaction of sinful life, because unless we are sinful, we cannot remain within this. A prisoner means a criminal. As soon as you find a person in the prison house, you should understand that he is a criminal. That criminality may be of different degrees. That is another thing. But he is a criminal. Similarly, anyone beginning from Brahma down to the germ in the stool, they are all sinful. All sinful. People will be surprised that Brahma is also sinful. Yes. Brahma has also desire that I shall be the supreme creature within this Brahmanda, whole universe. A little or more. Say, anyone who has got this desire that I shall enjoy in this material world, he is a sinner. That is sinful. Because, suppose something your, something belongs to you, and if I desire, how I shall take this possession of this thing, is not that criminal? Something belongs to somebody, and if you make a plan to possess that thing, is it not criminal? So, actually, Krishna is the bhokta. Bhoktaram jagadavasam sarvaloka maheshwaram. He is the proprietor, sarvaloka. Not a single plot of land belongs to him. Isabhasamidam sarvam. Actually, Krishna is the proprietor of everything, he is the enjoyer of everything. Then why I shall desire to enjoy and own the property? This is criminal. This is criminal. That may be in a small portion, and that is going on. The ant is also struggling for existence to possess a grain of sugar, and somebody is trying to possess some state, and somebody is trying to possess the whole universe. But the status of mentality is the same. So, this mentality means criminality. This mentality. How I shall become enjoyer? How I shall possess this? Krishna bhuliyadi bhogavan chakare. He forgets, when one forgets that Krishna is the enjoyer, Krishna is the proprietor. As soon as he forgets and tries to become himself the enjoyer or himself the proprietor, immediately Maya captures. Krishna bhuliya ji bhogavan chakare pasete maya tare japotiya dhare. Yes, come on. Now come under my jurisdiction, not there. Here. This is the point. Therefore, we living entities, we are described tatastha. Tatastha means marginal. Actually, we are spirit soul, our position in the spiritual world. But we are sometimes fallen down in this material world. On account of our desire to enjoy. That was Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's philosophy, not his manufactured philosophy, this is the actual position. He, when he instructed Sanatana Goswami, Sanatana Goswami put before him the question that I was a minister and I am a Brahmin, I am very learned. They say, of course, that I am Panditji, but actually I do not know what is my position. Actually I am fool number one. I do not know what is my position. These innocent people, they call me, I am Panditji, I am minister, I am this, I am that, and I accept that I am that. But actually I do not know what I am. That is the position. Everywhere you go, ask any prime minister that you are prime minister, but actually what you are? Will you remain prime minister forever? He or she cannot answer this question, or they evade this question. But this is really the question. Athat brahma jigyasa. One should try to understand what I am. But they do not read. They do not inquire, neither they are interested. So, foolish persons, they may be prime minister in this life, next life a job, they don't care, but this is not life. Atharva Brahma Jigyasa, one should inquire and purify himself. So this purificatory process, yeah, it is very simple. Try to take shelter of Mahatpada Rajovishekam. Vina Mahatpada Rajovishekam, it is stated by Prahlad Maharaj. Naishang Matistabad Urukramangrim. Urukrama. Urukrama means Krishna, whose activities are very, very great. Just like Krishna lifts the mountain. It is called Urukrama. Urukrama means his power is very, very great. Foolish person accepts a rascal as Bhagavan. But we are not so rascal. We accept Krishna, Bhagavan, Urukrama. He can lift when he can pick up the mountain immediately. He can keep on his finger. We want this kind of God. Not making like this and a grain of gold. We are not so poor. We want this kind of Krishna, Urukrama. So how this Urukrama, which one can surrender? Naishang matistabad Urukrama hungering. Hungering means this, leg. How one can be attached? Now what is the use of taking shelter of Krishna's lotus feet? Because these misgivings, this garbage of different types of desire will be finished. So how it is possible? Niskinchanaram mahiyasanga padarajubhisekam. So long one does not take the dust of the lotus feet of a devotee who is niskinchan, who has nothing to do with this material world, but he is exalted in Krishna consciousness. Unless we do that, there is no possibility. Mahiyasanga padarajubhisekam. This is interesting. So here Narada Muni is doing that. Mahiyasanga padarajubhisekam. Therefore, by eating the remnants of food stuff left by them, by washing their dishes, by washing their feet, everyone can do. Therefore, this association is required. If one associates with devotee, pure devotee, and somehow or other gives service, one another, to the spiritual master, to the Vaishnava, automatically he becomes purified. Automatically. Without any study of Vedanta, without any... simply by sincere service to the devotee. Evaṁ pravittasya. If one is engaged in this way, viśuddha cetasa, he becomes gradually clean of the dirty things accumulated in the heart. And tad-dharma, eva-atma-ruchi. And the saintly person and devotees, what is their business? The business is atma-ruchi, taste for Krishna consciousness. Prajayati. Automatically will develop. Therefore, every one of us, the members of Krishna consciousness, should remain purified always by the regulative principle given and chanting, so that everyone is Vaishnava and everyone is serving everyone. In this way, the association will purify the whole stock of it. This is the problem. Thank you.